Hi, this is David McCann for WebTNG. In this video, I'm taking a first look at WP Debug Toolkit. This is a new plugin for WordPress to help those who work with code. Whether you're writing plugins or themes from scratch, or you're just doing some code snippets or quote-unquote WordPress PHP, it's a set of power tools that will make the job easier. What I'm going to do in this video is kind of an overview tour. We'll look at some of the features, and then we'll have some discussion and conclusions at the end. I'm here on the WP Debug Toolkit website. If we go and look at the features, it's got keyboard shortcuts, highlights the errors in the debug logs, does real-time logging. It includes a standalone viewer app, which operates separately from WordPress. There are some UI enhancements, which makes it easy to find specific issues, to copy the debug log item, and in general, organize the UI of the log to make it easier to use. There are some filters for searching through the logs. There's a file viewer. If you click on a log item, it'll take you to that file where the error occurred. There's a crash recovery system. I mentioned there's a standalone viewer separate. And in addition to that, you can go in and disable themes or plugins if you get locked out of WordPress. So that's very convenient. We look at the pricing. It's very attractive pricing. $59 for one site, $89 for unlimited sites lifetime. And if you're watching this video close to the launch time, there's a coupon code in the video description. You'll get a little bit more off as a discount. This is a testing site I have set up using Breakdance. I'm going to go look at the plugins. You can see I have ACF Pro here for the team custom post type. Got Breakdance installed, I've got WP Vivid Backup installed, and WP Codebox, and then I've installed and enabled WP Debug Toolkit. That gives us this menu item here, and the links for the settings pages are across the top. Here's some getting started info, some keyboard shortcuts, some suggestion and recommendation to enable password protection on the log viewer. This page has information about how it works. So it's a standalone viewer, work even if you can't log into the WordPress dashboard. Has a PHP system health check, advanced log analysis, safe configuration, and then about the security and performance focus. Here's the site check. Yahoo 100%. Debug mode is inactive. Error logging is turned on. Display file permissions. Okay, and then some recommendations. Putting a password on the viewer is a pro feature, so we're going to need to enter the license key first. So I'll blur that out. And that's active. Okay, we will turn on debug mode, we'll turn on error logging, we will install the log viewer. Let's go ahead and enable the password protection. Okay, so password is set. What I want to do to test this is I want to create an error. I have a very old version of toolset views from 2019. Okay, a lot has changed with WordPress and new PHP versions and everything. So I'm expecting this to give us some errors. I'll install it and activate it. And oh, there it is. We got a critical error. Okay, can we go back and get back into the admin to disable this plugin? We cannot. So we're locked out of the admin. But we have the WP Debug Toolkit viewer enabled. So we can go to that manually, type in the URL WPDebugToolkit, and there's the viewer. Okay, we see the error here, the fatal error. Okay, I can copy that to send it off to support for a fix. We can view it. We can go here and see it takes us right to the line in the file where the error occurred. Here's the short, and here's the full debug message. That's nice, we've gotten that debug information, but how are we going to get back into the site? So there is this crash recovery option. I'm going to disable plugins, and if we go and look at the list, you see it's, I think what it did was rename the plugin directory or something. But anyway, what I'm going to do is enable it and go now to the list, and you see it's disabled all the plugins. So now we can get back into the admin. I can delete the offending plugin, okay, and then reactivate the others. So the debug toolkit saved our bacon there. So that's the tour and quick look at the features. Let's have some discussion and conclusions. WP Debug Toolkit is written by Elias Lista. He's a developer on the SoFly team, and he created this plugin because he needed it for his work. I think other people on the SoFly team are using it also. So, you know, it's being developed in the real world, in the trenches. That's the ethos of open source, that the developer scratches their own itch. They create a nice utility tool or program that does what they need it to do. They share it with friends, then it gets polished and shared more widely. That's kind of what open source is all about. I had the opportunity to chat with a developer while I was testing the plugin, and I ran into a couple of issues, and he's very responsive and fixed them right away. WP Debug Toolkit is, though, a utility program. Okay, it's a tool. It's not something that everybody needs that you need to install on every website. Something that'll be useful for developers. Given the functionality, the ease of use, and quality of life improvements that it brings, along with the attractive price, if you're a developer or power user who is doing some coding, if you don't have something comparable, WP Debug Toolkit is pretty much a no-brainer. So that's the look at the WP Debug Toolkit plugin. There's a link to the plugin website in the video description, along with a coupon code. If you're watching the video shortly after the plugin launches, then the coupon code should be active. Hope you found this video useful. Thank you for watching.